Hello, I'm Judy Stiles. Thank you for joining us today on Newsmakers. We're focusing on Missouri Southern today, and specifically the Missouri Southern Board of Governors. The board meets on a regular basis to visit with the administrators and others on campus, and we're going to find out about the role of the board and visit with the chairman of the board, Mitch McCumber. Thank you for being here today.
You're welcome, Judy. Glad to be here.
Let's start off with a general question for people who are watching. When we say the Board of Governors of Missouri Southern, how do you define that for someone?
Well, it's a group of us make up the Board of Governors. We currently have seven on the board. And our role primarily is governance. We work directly with the president of the university, as well as the other groups. And like I say, our primary role is governance.
Okay, so you have some specific roles dealing with policy making. Of course, I know finance, those types of concerns.
Absolutely. We have different committees that we set on, like today, for instance, we had our meeting, and we had an audit and budget committee meeting, and that's where all of the financial issues go through. We also have other committees that when other items pertaining to them, they meet, and those items go through their committees.
And having observed meetings and been there for many meetings, I know that you have the administrators from the campus reporting to you each time as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. They bring to us the things that are going on in their specific areas. Mm-hmm. Also at our meetings, a lot of times different items that are going on campus are highlighted. Today we heard about trumpet competition,
right,
that's going
mm-hmm.
on. We also got to meet the first young lady that is going to be going to the new medical school, coming to Joplin. So we have those every month as well.
Okay. And of course, board members are appointed by the governor. People might be curious, how does someone become a board member? So
that's correct.
Tell us a little bit about
that. That's correct. You go through an application process. So you send your application in, and then the governor selects who he wants to have on the board. And once you are selected, you go through a Senate confirmation process, and if you're approved by the Senate, then you become a board member at Missouri Southern.
Right. Now, a little personal aspect, you are actually coming back home serving on the board.
That's true. I am honored to be on this board. I graduated from Missouri Southern in 1985 mm-hmm. and got a degree in accounting from Missouri Southern, and at the time I was going to school, my soon-to-be wife was attending here as well, and she got her degree from here as well. And she passed away in 2009, and I'm now remarried, and my wife went to Missouri Southern as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's something that's very near and dear to me, and to be able to come back to this university and sit on this board is just one of the highlights of my career. It certainly is.
So having attended Missouri Southern, having that perspective as a student, do you feel that's really helping you now?
Absolutely. Absolutely, because many, many years ago when I was going to school, if it hadn't been for a place like Missouri Southern, of course back then it was called Missouri Southern State College,
right.
If it hadn't been for a place like Missouri Southern, I would have had a big difficulty going to school. I was born and raised in Miami, Oklahoma. Mm-hmm. The first 2 years of school I went to the junior college in Miami, NEO,
mm-hmm.
and then transferred up here. It was easy for me to transfer up here. I was able to drive back and forth. I lived at home while I was going to school. Money was difficult, and Southern, I was able to come here and get an education, and I will be eternally grateful for that.
And when you look at the history of Missouri Southern and this establishment, actually making higher education accessible to people in this part of Missouri was a big goal at that time.
Absolutely. Absolutely. If you read the history, of course, starting back in the days of the Joplin Junior College mm-hmm. and progressing down the line, there's been a couple of really good books written about the process and the dream of one day having a university, or a college at the time, and then a university in Joplin, Missouri. It was some people that were dreaming way ahead that made that happen.
So you graduated accounting.
Uh-huh.
Now tell us a little bit about your business career, where that led you after grad school.
I worked for a number of CPA firms and became a partner in a small firm. I'm still a CPA, a licensed CPA. And I guess for about 10 years I was in public accounting. And the last 23 years, I have had the privilege of working at Newmack Electric in Neosho.
Right. So you have been not only staying in the community, but you've been very active in the community as well.
Oh, absolutely. I'm very honored to have gotten to do the things I've gotten to do in my career. I sit on the hospital board in the Freeman Hospital Board in Neosho and the Freeman Hospital Board here in Joplin, and I'm on community CB&T's board,
right.
And then some industry boards as well. I've been very honored to get to do that.
Do you feel that Missouri Southern may have prepared you as well for that community involvement, that involvement in the community?
Absolutely. I absolutely do. The sense, I guess you would call it the sense of ownership and community, mm-hmm. Is one of the things that really got started here for me. So it's been very rewarding.
You've seen the school grow and develop over those years after graduating, seen a lot of faculty members. I imagine a lot of people impacted you as a student that you in turn can have seen their careers as well.
Absolutely. You know, I think back, you know, in the 80s when I was going to school here, and of course that seems like a long time ago now. I guess it is. I guess I'm really showing my age when I start talking about the years. But, you know, I had an accounting professor that was here my senior year, a gentleman by the name of Peter Huey. Mm-hmm. And he became a very dear friend of mine. He was actually best man in my wedding. Very dear friend, still in contact with him. And then since I've been on the board, earlier in the year we had a professor emeritus ceremony for some of the professors, and John Teedy and Jim Gray were there.
From the business school.
And I had them in school back in the 80s, and mm-hmm. and to be able to award that to them was just it was just an honor. It surely was.
You know, the saying is the teacher doesn't know how much they touch the life of a student. I mentioned that you could say that about many.
Absolutely, and you know, the list goes on and on. We could sit here and I could give you 20 other names mm-hmm. that did the same thing, because what it does for a young person going to school is it gives them the idea of what they can become with hard work. And, you know, I had so many instructors and professors here at this school that did that put those ideas in my head and would give you the drive to push to become that.
Mm-hmm. Now, do you feel that's a value that Missouri Southern is still retaining for their faculty?
Oh, absolutely. You know, Judy, you've been here for a long time. Mm-hmm. We've got some great folks at this institution, and our faculty is just top notch. I have the world of respect for those people. But when you go through all levels of the university, the different staff levels and that type of thing, everyone I have ever come in contact with this university, they're all about Missouri Southern. They take great pride in this university, and they are doing their life's work for this university.
And impacting those students who will be working in
Absolutely.
The future in our community.
Absolutely.
Well, let's turn to the board. You're the chairperson of the board.
So yes, I am.
Another question someone might ask, what does a chairperson of the board do? How do you explain that?
Well, primarily the role is to conduct the meeting, to lead the meeting. I also appoint committees, the standing committees that we talked about earlier.
Right.
Those are appointed by me. And that's just the primary duty. is to conduct the meeting, keep the meeting running, and to conduct the meeting along with the rules and regulations and that type of thing.
Right. Well, of course, we're recording this program right after the March meeting, so
that's right.
We'd be remiss if we don't talk about what happened
Absolutely.
At the March meeting. And a lot of people watch the meetings, they read about them in the paper, they see the news releases, and of course, March is the time when you had some discussion regarding tuition.
That's right.
And that's an issue that comes around every year, but this year is perhaps in a little different light based on the challenges facing the state. You voted to increase tuition to, I guess, eventually to a total of $183.37 starting in the fall.
That's correct. That's correct. Excuse me. It was a two-part increase. The first part was to put on the books an amount that is allowable for 2017,
right.
And I believe that amount was 0.7% is what pops in my head. The second piece was the amount that would be allowable for 2018, and I think it was 2.1%. And all these are driven by the Consumer Price Index.
Mm-hmm.
And we raise this tuition in accordance with the Senate Bill 389, which
right.
is our governing rule on tuition increases. And, you know, we've had news of some budget cuts coming our way that are going to be quite significant. And this was just one of the processes that we have to go through each year. And anytime we have it, one of these increases, it is a hard decision to make, but one that has to be made because mm-hmm. of the financial integrity of the organization has to be kept. Right. So that's what we did today.
And of course, we're talking about in-state tuition, and then Missouri Southern has something called Lion Pride tuition, which
that's right.
Talk a little about the community, what this means for the university, how this.
You know,
is.
It's been one of the big drivers to our enrollment increases because it basically passes the in-state tuition to the surrounding states mm-hmm. Around Missouri, so we're able to recruit with the in-state tuition a lot of the. States that originally we couldn't, and also it includes Texas.
So the board, every state that actually
That's
physically
right.
touches Missouri.
That's
right.
Right, and Texas.
And Texas. Mm-hmm.
So that has been one of the drivers, among many other things, as to the enrollment increases that we've been enjoying, that quite frankly a lot of places haven't been enjoying.
And that's part of the news when you look at Missouri Southern. In the last two semesters, at least, we've had the enrollment going up. That's been a nice trend.
Absolutely, and very much needed. You know, we've had, like I say, we've had a series of budget cuts from the state, and that revenue has to come from somewhere. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, the way Senate Bill 389 works, when it was passed, we were one of the less expensive institutions in the state. And when you're limited to CPI increases, you stay one of the least.
So you're always lagging behind.
You're always lagging behind. So somewhere, someday, that will have to change because we're going to need a bump sometime to get up to a point to where we can continue on with the quality that we all have come to expect from Missouri Southern. And that'll happen at a point in the future sometime.
So there's a lot of eyes on Jefferson City, a lot of communication. I mentioned the president gave a report about what's happening in Jefferson City. You working with the local lawmakers, the people who are making those decisions.
Absolutely. And, you know, Judy, I have to say, a lot of the local folks in Jefferson City, I know very well, and we have a great group of people doing everything that they can for us there. I have a lot of respect for them and the jobs they have to do of balancing everything within the state. And I know they really work hard to do everything they can for us.
It's nice you feel that we have a strong delegation representing
this. I absolutely do, and we have for quite some time. Mm-hmm. You know, Senator Richard, President Pro Tem of the Senate, is a very strong voice in Jefferson City, former Speaker of the House. Mm-hmm. And I know he has worked along with all the area representatives and senators to do the very best they can for the university.
So having those people advocate and spread the news about Missouri Southern and Jefferson City certainly
Absolutely.
Helps.
Absolutely. And anytime a person is in Jefferson City, that's the main thing that people will ask me about, not mm-hmm. my own business, but how's everything going at Missouri Southern? Everybody's always interested.
Great. Well, at the same time that we have these challenges, we have opportunities on campus. They talked in the meeting today about ongoing construction.
Absolutely. Nixon Hall and the improvements that are being made to Reynolds Hall. A lot of changes coming to the campus. Mm-hmm. We've already seen quite a few with the construction of the quad, which have been very successful. And the North End Zone facility, just to name a couple. And I know you've been in that facility mm-hmm. over there. And what a facility it is, you know, for the student athletes, first of all. But for other functions as well, I've been to a number of functions in that big meeting room that overlooks right. the field. Mm-hmm. And we have a state-of-the-art facility right there, both for where meetings can be had, but for the what it does for the student athlete over there. Mm-hmm. It's just a great place.
Now you mentioned the quads, and housing's an aspect as Missouri Southern grows. We're getting more students who need a place to stay if they're coming here.
Absolutely. That's been, the quads have been very popular. If you mm-hmm. talk to any of the students that have gotten rooms there, they rank them very highly. So it has been something that has been a big improvement at Southern.
Now, something else mentioned at the meeting was the Child Development Center, which was a process already started last year, but you're actually going to be moving from one facility to another
correct,
for the children.
Correct. That's part of the process we're going through as we're preparing for some of these things that are coming into the future.
Mm-hmm. So we'll be having that happening while we're talking. Things for the future, I know the governor had to hold back some funding and make some cuts. The dental school, there was some discussion of that today. People might be curious, well, is Missouri Southern going to get this dental school? What are your feelings on that?
We sure hope so. We sure hope so. That would be a big boost for not only Southern, but for the area. And I understand some of the last budget news to come out is some of the money is being put back in for that. Mm-hmm. Not all of it. It's still a work in progress, but we remain optimistic and certainly hope that's something that does happen.
Okay. So something that's still on that future radar that we're
Absolutely.
Hoping that would happen here at the
Absolutely,
university.
Absolutely,
it is. And tying those together. Of course, academics a big part of the university, obviously, in the discussions at the meeting today. We heard some presentations about the medical school ties to Missouri Southern and the Yours to Lose program.
You know, that was a great presentation. I know you broadcast the board meeting on the station here, and that's something I hope people get to watch, because the group of people that we've had apply for that, students that are top students not only in Joplin, not only in Neosho, not only in Newton, Jasper, McDonald County, mm-hmm. we're talking top students nationwide are applying to Missouri Southern for the Yours to Lose, and what opportunity that is. And it's just the first year, you know. So as we move forward, we'll see that year after year. And from a student standpoint, to be able to go to Missouri Southern, to get into that program, to transition from a bachelor's degree right into med school, and go to med school right here in Joplin. Did you ever think you would see a day that we would be talking about that?
The community.
But it's real, mm-hmm. and it's happening, and what an impact it has on the community. You know, hiring doctors in Southwest Missouri, Northeast Oklahoma, Southeast Kansas, Northwest Arkansas, a lot of times it's not the easiest thing to do. A lot of times doctors don't want to go to areas that have a smaller population.
They want to go
to
big cities, right?
To a big city. And to have a med school right here in Joplin, that will be a big improvement on that very thing.
And that is, for the viewers, explain a collaborative effort that, you know, the people...
Absolutely. KCUMB coming down here, there was a group of people that worked very, very hard to get that med school here. Some of the people that led the charge on that, and I will be remiss and I will leave people out, but a couple names that pop to mind is Rudy Farber in Neosho and Larry McIntyre here
over the Joplin community.
Joplin, absolutely. Just really carried that dream along and did great work making that happen. And it's just been a big deal.
And that's something that was in the works or discussion for a number of years. I mean, I can remember board meetings years ago when somebody brought up the idea for the first time.
Absolutely. I wish I could remember when I first heard about it, but for years and years, and especially sitting on the Freeman board, we would hear discussion about it, and then it would look like, you know, that perhaps it wouldn't happen, and you wouldn't hear about it for a month or two, and it would come back up, and there were a core group of people that kept that dream alive and kept pushing for it to happen.
And you mentioned the community ties. This was an instance of a community investment, a community effort as well.
Absolutely. As I remember, and I may be off on these numbers because I'm talking off the top of my head, I believe about $30 million had to be raised mm-hmm. through commitments to get the med school coming this direction. And it got done through a lot of hard work of a lot of people.
Of course, we have the medical, the biological aspects of academics. Today, you also had a presentation on the fine arts side talking about the trumpets and the program that we have here at Missouri Southern for that.
The gentleman that spoke to us today, Mr. Green, mm-hmm. Has put together a group of these fantastic trumpet players to compete in this contest. It's in Denver, I believe. I believe is where it is. And we heard about that today and what they have accomplished. And as I understand, they had to send in a YouTube video that was judged for this finalist group. Mm-hmm. And they just knocked it out of the park.
That's great.
And they gave us a list of the people they were competing against, and it was, you know, schools like Florida State and Arkansas State and mm-hmm. Oklahoma State, big
universities,
big places. And we're right there just going neck and neck with them.
So that's another one of those points of pride at Missouri
Southern.
Oh,
absolutely.
When you look at the campus.
And I believe the the competition is the end of March, so we sure wish them the very best.
So when you look across campus at Missouri Southern, you hear the news, a lot of different areas, there's a lot, do you feel positive about the many things happening campus-wide that are happening here?
You know, I couldn't be prouder as to what's going on here. You know, I used a comment today of momentum, and I guess I'm stealing the advertising
the
campaign,
marketing campaign,
right, that Cassie Mathis and her group put together. But that's really how I feel. Mm-hmm. There is a lot of momentum at this university. We're doing a lot of really good things. We're graduating some fantastic students with a lot of capacity and a lot of capability. And you know, when you talk about Missouri Southern to your friends in the community, you hear positive things, mm-hmm. and that's so important. So yes, I think that it's very positive what's going on right now.
Now, you mentioned Missouri Southern and the ties to the community. Do you feel that we've had increasing ties throughout those years? Missouri Southern's had a presence at, let's say, the third Thursday. There seems to be a growing community ties to the
Absolutely.
University.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, it kind of goes back to what we talked about a little bit ago, and that is this pride of ownership in a community. Mm-hmm. And I think that all ties together. I think we have fantastic support from not only the community of Joplin, but all the areas that we touch. I think there is just a lot of support. I know I have people talk to me often about it.
So community support, but regional support.
You know, absolutely.
As we look throughout
yes,
the region,
right.
People coming in and supporting that. Of course, the opportunities that Missouri Southern, we talk about the growth and things that are happening on campus. There's always challenges. You mentioned the budget, which is something that probably no matter what year, the situation with the state, you're still going to have those types of challenges.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Absolutely, you do. But you know, in any business, if you will, mm-hmm. isn't that always the challenge?
Mm-hmm.
So it's one of those things that you find a way and you work through it.
Now, Missouri Southern, people are familiar with the university, have heard the term the great game of education.
Yes.
For the community at large, you know, what does this mean in terms of the university kind of dealing with some of these challenges?
Well, the great game of education has been a collaborative effort from a lot of people on this campus that has been based off of the Jack Stack model of the great game of business.
Mm-hmm.
And I was very fortunate in the very beginning of this thing to sit in on some meetings when it was being discussed as to how do we get from this point to this point as far as using this model. And I know, I remember Dr. Sherry Buchanan was on the board at that point in time. She sat through several of those meetings. And the staff and faculty of the university has just grabbed hold of this and has really run with it. And it basically brings everybody in the university in on the planning process as to how to most efficiently run the organization. It's not just a few people saying, this is what we're going to do.
Mm-hmm.
It is a group effort. Dr. Scott Cragen and then Jeff Gibson, they have been leaders on getting this ready. And like I say, I'm sure I'm leaving out dozens of others, so don't anybody be mad at me about that. But those are two people that I know I've worked with on this. And it really has pointed out a lot of opportunities to put us in a better financial situation.
I know it was stated at the meeting today by, I think, one of your members of the board that thanks to some actions that have already been taken, Missouri Southern is not necessarily facing as dire a situation as it could be as an institution.
Well, let's just back up for a minute and think where we would be with the news that we've been receiving if we had declining enrollment and had not taken any steps to become as efficient as we possibly could be.
Mm-hmm.
Think of where we would be right now. And so we've been way ahead of the curve with the direction that we've been going.
So you have a system in place to deal with many
Absolutely.
Of these challenges coming
or
through.
Or at least helps with them.
Help with it as
Absolutely.
You're coming through. Well, as you look at the role of the board, you mentioned the members you have, everybody's putting a time through committees. People in the public say, well, they have a meeting once a month. But as board members, you put in a lot of time behind the scenes that we don't see.
Absolutely, you do. You know, there's a lot of, you come on a board like this and there's a learning curve.
Mm-hmm.
And you know a little bit more about the process 3 months in than you did in the beginning, and then 6 months in and 9 months in. So there is that process that you go through. The administration is great to lend their time if questions come up. Hey, I need some explanation on this. I don't quite understand what this is or why we're doing this. And our board that we have, actually, and because there's been people come on the board and people go off the board while I've been here, put any of those people in this line, they've always been willing to do whatever's asked of them. Whatever's asked of them. And this year, from the board chair perspective, you're very appreciative of that because people are always willing to work however you ask them to work.
So it's really a teamwork effort on the
board. Oh, 100%. Not only the board, but with administration and faculty and staff. It's a total collaborative effort.
And working that together. Absolutely. Well, I know that each year you have a retreat and you talk about goals for the future.
Right.
That will be coming up this summer to kind of look at.
Yes. I believe we're going to get together the morning of our June.
They mentioned June 14th.
June 14th. Mm-hmm. Yes, we're going to meet and we're going to do some strategic planning. We haven't had one of those sessions this year yet, and we had originally thought we would have it in April, but we have some other things we've got to take up in April, so we've moved it back to that June meeting. We did that this week.
But is that an important step for the board to have?
Absolutely.
Where you can say, where are we? Where are we going?
And you got to have guideposts, and you got to have a direction, and you got to, you know, any plan that's worth anything has to be reevaluated. Mm-hmm. And it's just that process of looking at, okay, this is the direction that we are headed. Is this where we want to go? And it's always a tweak and a change.
Right. Well, I know as board members, you also, when we have commencement, we have everyone on the stage, share your feelings as you see those graduates who have been here walk across the stage.
Well, it is, it's an honor to know those students got their education here at Missouri Southern, and that they are going into the future, into their field of study, and all the opportunity they have ahead of them. Mm-hmm. It's just an honor knowing what these students have in front of them.
Well, Mr. McCumber, I'd like to thank you very much today for joining us, and I appreciate your time after a full day of meetings and activities.
Absolutely.
Here on campus.
It's been my honor to be here, Judy.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And I'd like to thank you, the viewers, for joining us this week on Newsmakers. I'm Judy Stiles. Hope you can join me again next week at the same time on this station. We'll see you then.